Hello, I'm a professional software developer here in Germany. And for the last 5 years, I was using an external monitor with 27-inch, which was the Dell UltraSharp U2715H. It had a resolution of 1440p, which resulted in 109 ppi. PPI stands for pixel per inch. At work, I use a dual monitor setup. These are two 24-inch monitors with 1080p resolution each, and this results in 92 ppi. A couple of months ago, I was somewhat bothered with the relatively low resolution of these monitors, especially when compared with my 14-inch laptop. It has a 1080p monitor, which results in 157 ppi, which is quite a bit more. So I was thinking, isn't there something with a little bit higher resolution, perhaps something with more like a 4K resolution and 30 somewhat inches? So I did some digging and I found the 31.5-inch Dell UltraSharp U3219H, which has a 4K resolution, and this results in 140 ppi. So I bought it in last December for little over 800 euros, including taxes. There is no sponsoring involved. So now the question is, is it nice enough and does it have enough space to be worth its money from a professional software developer's perspective? As always, the short answer first. And in short, you can say, yeah, it's mostly a good solution. And that's why. The Dell UltraSharp U3219Q comes with a huge box. It's really, really big. Inside you find a 1.8 meter long power cord, a USB Type-C cable, which is 1 meter long. It is of very good quality. Also, there is a DisplayPort cable and a USB upstream cable. There is a color calibration factory report for exactly this unit, although I do not know what any of these numbers mean. I generally prefer color calibrated monitors. It stands on a massive foot and weighs around 10 kilograms in total. It has very narrow edges of around 7 to 8 millimeters, which is also very nice to look at. Although the product name U3219Q suggests a 32-inch monitor, it is actually only 31.5 inches. Hey Dell, what's with the missing half inch? It has a reasonably high PPI of 140, which makes very sharp images and reading of text is very comfortable. In case you are wondering why the resolution is so much lower than, for example, compared with your typical smartphone. Typically, the distance between your eyes and a monitor is higher than the distance between your eyes and a smartphone. Therefore, a monitor does not need that high of a resolution. But more on resolutions later. After all, this is large enough to display even 4 windows at a time. It is roughly 4 times the size of a 14-inch laptop. As you can see, it could fit 4 times in it. The monitor has a built-in 90 watts power supply for anything you can connect to the USB-C cable. Over the USB-C connection, video will also be transferred. There is a built-in USB hub with 4 USB 3.0 ports, so you can connect some of your peripherals directly to the monitor. In essence, this makes the monitor work just like a docking station. Over just one cable you can connect, for example, your laptop to it. I have connected my keyboard, my mouse and a backup USB drive directly to the monitor, so every time I connect my laptop via USB-C, everything is connected. The result is a nice and clean desk. Also, it is very useful to switch between laptops. Now let's dive deeper for a little bit longer answer to the question. One information up front. If the fonts appear too small for your taste, Windows provides you the option to change the scaling of fonts and windows system-wide. You can use this to make fonts and windows appear larger on a given monitor. For this, you open the Windows Control Panel, go to the System and Display, and there you'll find the scaling option. I have set this to 125% for both of my displays. You should change every monitor to the same value, otherwise some applications might not be able to scale the windows correctly. Afterwards, log off from Windows and log on back to activate the changes properly. So, is there enough space for a software developer? Let's look at monitor areas and resolutions of different monitor sizes and compare them. A very nice guy on the internet called Sven created a PPI calculator which calculates very reasonable estimates for areas and PPIs. Link in the description below. Let's look at a typical areas and resolutions starting with the aforementioned monitor sizes. Okay, let's go to sven.de dpi and there you have horizontal and vertical resolutions, are diagonal, and it calculates the square area in inches and in centimeters as well as the PPI. So first example was my 27-inch 1440 display, which is this one. And here we see this amounts to 2009 square centimeters and round about 109 PPI. To compare this with the 24-inch displays, which were 1080p resolution, and 24-inch, which is 1920 pixels by 1080 pixels and 24-inch. And this results in 1587 square centimeters and 92 PPI. And if when we compare this two with a full, with a 1080p display on a 14-inch laptop, so I enter here 14-inch. We see this one has 540 square centimeters, but the resolution is very high, much higher with 157 PPI. So how does this compare to a 32-inch monitor, or to be exact, the 31 Dell UltraSharp? We have this preset here, which is 4K and 31.5 inches. This results in 2735 square centimeters and round about 140 PPI. There are other monitors with higher resolutions, but as I mentioned before, most of them have lower resolutions. For example, you can find 1440p resolutions, something like this one with 35 inches. It has a comparable area, which is 2800 square centimeters, but only 107 PPI roundabout. Just for comparison, let's look at the iPhone 12 with a 6.1 inch display, and iPhone 12 has a resolution of 2532 by 1170 and is 6.1 inches. This amounts to 91 square centimeters and a resolution of 557 ppi. This means that the 31.5-inch Dell has 86% of the work area of two 24-inch monitors side by side, as 2735 square centimeters are 86% of 2 times 1587 square centimeters. But the area is not as wide. Instead, it has a different height to width ratio, which gives you more height. Personally, I find this to be more useful than two 24-inch monitors side by side, as these simply create a lot of white space and a lot of use cases. As mentioned before, the Dell resolution is over 50% higher, which contributes to sharper images and nicer fonts. To show you how this looks like hands-on, I have decided to film the monitor in order for you to grasp the proportions. I know this is not the best decision quality-wise. Let's look at the two websites on Chrome's browser side by side and afterwards at four websites. So, let's start with the Chrome browser and go, for example, to New York Times. Windows has a nice built-in snapping feature, perhaps you know it since Windows 7. And for example, let's make another Chrome browser. So you'll see there is plenty of room for two full screen displays of each page. And as I mentioned before, the nicer the advantage is you have more height than, for example, on two 24-inch monitors side by side. You can even have four browser windows or any type of windows side by side. So let's open it that way. And let's make let's make another window. Let's look at, say, YouTube. I accept everything. Lo-fi, hip-hop, let's say. This one could run here, and you could, for example, say, let's have a look on my script, which is here in a Visual Studio Code, and you see there's plenty of room. The nice thing about this is you don't have to turn your head that much, but have nonetheless everything visible. Dell also provides a nice tool which is called the Dell Display Manager, and this one gives you more options on the snapping features. So let's look into it. You can say, for example, to have the Display Manager always create three columns or three rows or four two columns and one column in three rows. So let's say you want to have three rows side by side, and then the following happens. You can place a window in one of the rows and it will snap automatically. Of course, it is nonetheless possible to not have a window snapped. In that case, you have to press the shift key, and if you press it, then the auto snapping feature is disabled. So you can place it somewhere else. Or you could say you want to have a bigger and a smaller row. So let's say this one. So you could do something like that, that you have your Visual Studio code on the one side and some tech information or specification on the other side. It works quite nice. Now let's look at some developer tools. For example, how about the Chrome browser with the developer tools? Let's go to, for example, YouTube. I accept everything. And let's open the developer tools. So here you see there is plenty of room to have the display of the website itself, and also the elements and the styles, or one could look at the network activity, and each request can be viewed with headers and preview. So there's very much space, it's plenty of space for everything you need. Next, let's look at Visual Studio Code. For example, I have a small project here. I have even 4 files side by side and even a terminal down here. Finally, let's look at, for example, DaVinci Resolve. This one takes a second. So there's plenty of room. You can see your media storage. You can see the cut perspective. You can see the whole timeline, a big view window on the edit screen. Even with 2 displays side by side, all your sound, there's plenty of room. Of course, the last option is you can always use is to use your laptop side by side with your monitor. So for example, you could basically show the Lo-Fi Girl on your laptop and have always your project on your main window, or if you are coding, you can use your code on the main display and have your notes on the second one. So, is the Dell UltraSharp U3219Q worth the money? All things considered, I tend to say yes. It provides a sufficiently high resolution and very nicely balanced colors. With its PPI of 140, texts and images will appear sufficiently clear. This also enables you to work effortlessly as it decreases the strain on your eyes. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video, please subscribe my channel and leave a like. If you want to learn more or have questions about the monitor, feel free to write me in the comments below. I plan to do more reviews, deep dives and guides in the future. My content aims to help and educate the passionate and privacy-aware user. I look forward to present you more videos soon. That's all for now. See you soon. Bye-bye.